أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Dear friends, a couple of years ago, a book with the title The Hacking of the American Mind, written by Dr. Robert Lustig. You find them on YouTube. He had several presentations. He is here in this book talking about how the capitalist system hijacked the brain for the purpose of influencing it or intoxicating it with the material stuff to pursue or achieve happiness. So here in this book, he tried to differentiate between happiness and pleasures. So he put it into several categories, one of them seven keys differences. The first, pleasure is short-lived. Happiness is long-lived. So all of us, we know pursuing pleasure of what they do nowadays in society, or drinking or dating, or this is very short, for a very short-lived, while happiness doesn't have any boundaries. Second, pleasure is visceral, happiness is ethereal. So pleasures, it's very obvious, is related to the body, to the brain, to the heart, to the taste, to the stomach, while happiness is spiritual and overwhelming without any boundaries. Pleasure is taking. Happiness is giving. So pleasures, when you pursue pleasure, you go and get this or that and consume it. So you feel the pleasure, the hedonistic life, and happiness comes from charity, wiping the head of an orphan, giving money to the needy. You feel overwhelming happy feeling. Pleasures can be achieved with substances. Happiness cannot be achieved with substances. So here, pleasure, like drinking liquor, using drugs, gluttony, hedonistic life, or fun and play and sex and all of that, it requires substance, something. While happiness is spiritual and does not need alcohol or drugs or etc. Pleasure is experienced alone. Happiness is experienced in social groups. So pleasure, when somebody go out to the bar or to date or to do whatever of seeking pleasure, nobody else will enjoy it but himself. So kind of selfishness. While happiness, when the father gives money to the poor, the wife will be happy, the children will be happy, everyone will be satisfied. The extremes of pleasure all lead to addiction, whether they be substances or behavior, like drinking, drugs, sexual addictions, gambling. All of these will oblige the person to have more and more, become a slave to that, and he will be addicted. Yet there's no such thing as being addicted to much happiness. Finally, and most importantly, 7, pleasure is tied to dopamine, the pleasure biochemical neurotransmitter, while happiness is tied to serotonin, the happiness biochemical neurotransmitter. So here we are talking about two centers in the brain. The addiction center, the dopamine center, where all the addiction from alcohol to drugs to gambling to sex addiction, pornography addiction, all these addictions, the center of it in the hypothalamus in the dopamine center. While serotonin is present in the whole body, 90% of it in the guts, and in the platelet of the blood, and 1% in the brain, as in between the synapses and the neurons, where happiness increases that level of serotonin. And it's completely different mechanisms. And we know that excess dopamine, which lead to addiction, erodes both present and future happiness. In a simple neuroscience terms, dopamine down-regulates serotonin. So the results, pleasures kill happiness. Pleasures kill happiness. No wonder we find families with a father addicted to alcohol or drugs, or women or men, or gambling. He ruined the happiness of the whole family, and himself, of course. So here, coming to the commercials, anything they want to sell. I was watching the other day the broken shield of the car. They promote their product, but with it, a whole family jumping and happy, and that's how every medicine, every commercial for medicine, for merchandise, everything, you find people happy, smiling, jumping, family, mother, father, children. Entice you to go and buy more. Things you might need or things you don't need. And that's enhanced when they hire those lovable personalities from sport or movies or whatever, and they pay them hundreds of millions of dollars. If it doesn't work, they wouldn't pay that amount of money. There's no free lunch. So this is where the danger. They sell all these material junk. You see your attic, go and check it. Every item you bought, you took the car and you went and you hoped that you and your children will be happy. But happiness never comes, because these are two different things. For the children, they need to know helping out at home, at schools, caring about others, feeling, and giving charity to the poor and the needy, and doing all of these things which we know from our morals and belief systems to do to others. This is how you become happy. May God bless you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.